and lost their lives, and more than 500 were hospitalized. Many are still fighting for their lives. We're thinking of each family affected by this horrific shooting, and our hearts are with the city of Las Vegas. But if this isn't the right time to talk about how to better prevent gun violence in this country, I don't know when it is. The time to talk about gun violence is now. This country belongs to all of us, and it is up to us to make sure it is safe for all Americans. As we collectively grieve and details continue to unfold, we have a responsibility to act to prevent further gun violence in America.
The thoughts and prayers offered by many of our legislators are not enough. Our Senator, James Lankford, offered his prayers and said that this act would cure evil. Yet when it comes time to vote for common sense measures like universal background checks, he votes no. Senator Chris Murphy of Connecticut, one of the strongest voices we have in Congress for gun violence prevention, summed it up well. He said, thoughts and prayers of politicians are cruelly hollow if they are paired with continued legislative indifference.
Yes. Right.
He also said that our thoughts and prayers need to be matched by action. Our job is not just to send good thoughts. The reason why we exist is to act, to change the laws of the nation, to address challenges that our constituents face. Americans shouldn't have to worry about being shot at outdoor concerts, movie theaters, elementary schools, churches, and nightclubs. This nation's gun homicide rate is 25 times higher than the average of other developed nations.
Oh, that's remarkable.
93 Americans are shot and killed every day. This is a uniquely American crisis, and we don't have to live like this.
The connecting element between all these tragedies is that it is far too easy for people with dangerous histories to get their hands on guns in our country. This week, the gun lobby is pushing to gut our nation's laws governing the use of silencers. I don't even want to think about how much worse this tragedy could have been for all the people there, including the first responders, if they hadn't heard the gunshots or where they were coming from. In coming weeks, the gun lobby will also push for so-called concealed carry reciprocity, dangerous legislation that would gut states' gun laws and allow countless people carry hidden loaded guns across the country with no background checks or safety training. This law wouldn't create a national standard for who can carry a hidden loaded gun in public like the NRA would like you to believe. Instead, it would force every state to accept the concealed carry standards of every other state, no matter how weak or non-existent those standards may be.
This should be a moment of reckoning. For years, the NRA and their allies in Congress have pushed a guns everywhere agenda. We routinely see what that's gotten us, a devastating pattern of countless Americans shot and killed. Our country is at a defining moment. Do we want to live in a country where the NRA leadership's guns everywhere for everyone with no questions asked vision prevails? Where we are all armed to the teeth in every moment of our daily lives? Or do we want to live in a country where we feel safe in our daily lives? Do we want to fight for stronger gun laws that will make us all safer?
Our group, Moms Demand Action, chooses to advocate for stronger gun safety laws. We do this by contacting our legislators, by phone, email, and Twitter, by lobbying at the Capitol in person, by writing letters, by working to get candidates with gun sense elected.
Yep. There you go.
Whatever it takes to make our voices heard. For the past 2 years, we have defeated the gun lobby's agenda in Oklahoma by speaking out and letting our legislators know that we're watching and that we don't agree. We must demand action to end gun violence, and we need your help.
At all of our meetings, we have calls to action. We'd like to ask all of you here today to be called to action as well. Here are several ways that you can take action starting tonight. Text silencers to 64433 and you'll be connected with your congressman. We will provide you with a script and you can tell them to oppose the silencers provision in the SHARE Act and that you oppose concealed carry reciprocity. gun laws need to change. You can join us at our next Moms Demand Action meeting at the Red Sill Library on October 24th at 6:30 p.m. You don't have to be a mom.
We have a lot of
things. You can like our Facebook page, or you can join us at Canvas for a Gun Sense State Senate candidate this weekend. While it's a mass tragedy that brings us together tonight, we must remember that there are Americans dying every day due to gun violence, and we need to continue with this hard work until we put an end to the violence.
There is a poster outside that you all can take a picture of that will allow you to know what all these actions are that you can take, so you can take pictures and